Sticking with priests for the moment, who was the mad monk of Russia?
Rasputin is...
Why was it not him?
Well, because he was the lover of the Russian queen.
Is that what you're basing all your knowledge of history?
He was a cat that really was gone.
Why was he not the mad monk of Russia?
He wasn't mad and he wasn't a monk.
He wasn't a monk, is the truth of it. He was never a monk. The guy who referred to himself as the mad monk was a one-time friend of Rasputin's. He was called Sergei Trufanov, also known as Ilya Dor. There he is. And he wrote his memoirs. They were published in New York in 1918, and he published them as The Mad Monk of Russia. And that book is one of the primary sources that we have for the life of Rasputin. So the mad monk is the less famous Ilya Dor and not Rasputin, but because we know so much about Rasputin from this book, The Mad Monk of Russia, that is why we associate him. Yeah. I think everybody knows that. Rasputin was a faith healer, and he parlayed his claim to be able to help the son of the Tsar into a position of tremendous influence in the Russian imperial court. I mean, Rasputin himself, unbelievably poorly educated. His diary, he misspells the word diary.
So you think it's all about milk?
Yeah, possibly. He claimed that by sleeping with women, he could take on their sins and help them find the grace
of God. I've tried that. I'll take your sins on.
Yeah.
There's a theory, a sort of rogue theory about Putin being the reincarnation of Rasputin, and there was a thing that was about they took some of Putin's pubic hair and then they took some of Rasputin's residual testicular fluid, and the DNA was exactly the same.
So, I'm struggling with the whole of that story.
I do like the phrase residual testicular fluid.
I'm getting to need...
I should be using that again, I'm not sure. Can I have a vodka and residual testicular fluid, please?
So we're going to need an unwashed sheet of some kind.
Yeah, Putin left his pubic hairs everywhere, isn't it?
They scraped it off the back of a tiger.
So the circumstances of Rasputin's death, I mean, they are stuff of legend, but what is beyond dispute is that the leader of the assassins, Prince Felix Yusupov, was a member of the Bullingdon Club while he was an undergraduate at Oxford. And in fact, Yusupov, that's him and his wife, Irina, they are the reason why films today carry... You know, there's a statement on films that says any similarity to any living person is entirely coincidental. He and his wife sued MGM over a film called Rasputin and the Empress... produced in 1932, and they won substantial compensation. This is a wonderful story, which I really like, because it sort of makes people more human when you look at their story. Rasputin was actually married and he had three kids, and one of his kids, Maria, she, after the revolution, she emigrated to the United States, and she worked in a circus where she used to every night do a mime of her father's death. She then graduated to becoming a lion tamer. Unfortunately, her career in the circus was cut short when she was mauled by a bear. What are the chances you're working as a lion tamer?
It must have happened during dinner.
Interestingly, she billed herself as the daughter of the mad monk, so it clearly had become a phrase that people used. And she went on in the Second World War to work as a riveter in the shipyards in California. She died in 1977. The mad monk of Russia wasn't Rasputin, it was... some bloke you've never heard of. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.